There have been many documented cases of people who are allergic to excipients. I will mention two here. There is a story published on the internet by a woman called Lonnie from California. She tells about her daughter's prolonged illness. The daughter initially became sick because she was allergic to the excipients of the health supplements that she was taking. So she started receiving medical treatment, but the more the doctors treated her, the sicker she became. And until they finally realized that she was allergic to the excipient microcrystalline cellulose. So here is Lonnie's story.
Are hidden ingredients in pills making you sicker? 2 years ago, we discovered that my daughter was allergic to microcrystalline cellulose, one of the most common fillers in pills. The easiest tip-off that the adverse reaction is likely to be to the excipients is if you initially feel better after starting a new medication, and then around day 3 begin to feel worse. Just 2 months prior to that discovery, my daughter had an allergic reaction and was diagnosed with mast cell activation syndrome. This followed a lengthy illness and treatment for Lyme, Ehrlichia, and Bartonella. Despite treatment, her health continued to decline precipitously. It was the most terrifying time of her illness. At the time, I'd never even heard of excipients in medications, let alone microcrystalline cellulose. What are excipients? Every ingredient in a medication that isn't the active drug itself is labeled as an excipient. Ideally, excipients are inert and have no pharmacological effect. But there have been growing reports of adverse reactions to these extra ingredients. Excipients can range anywhere from simple organic ingredients, like cornstarch or sugar, to more complex substances with potential for toxicity at higher doses or after prolonged use. Here's how we discovered my daughter's allergy to microcrystalline cellulose. In the fall of 2016, my daughter had developed sensitivities to multiple chemicals and could eat only two foods without having an allergic reaction. Thankfully, one of her doctors thought to question what fillers were being used in one of her medications, ketotifen, a mast cell stabilizer. I called the pharmacy and was told the prescription contained two ingredients, ketotifen and lactose. Knowing she'd been lactose intolerant for years, I felt angry and relieved all at once. I thought, "Eureka, this is it." But just knowing isn't enough. Later that day, her doctor recommended another treatment. After picking up the new prescription, out of caution, I only gave my daughter a half dose, and she had an allergic reaction. That day, I emailed my doctor. He replied, "Yes, I've seen microcrystalline cellulose act as a trigger in some people." I was not happy. But at least we had determined that she had a problem with microcrystalline cellulose, an important piece of our puzzle. So, I quickly went to the cupboard and discovered that every single one of her vitamins and supplements contained microcrystalline cellulose. We'd been unwittingly sabotaging our efforts all along. My daughter recovered when we stopped using products containing excipients.
An article published in October in 2020 in the South African newspaper, The Report, tells a story of a woman called Labuschagnè, and this is her story.
I suffered from hormone imbalances for a long time. I managed it using Eltroxin for many years. In February 2018, I suddenly had a complete personality change. I developed a temper, mood swings, and depression. I also suffered palpitations, joint pains, itchy dry skin, and a relentless appetite. I found a Facebook group for people with hormone imbalances. Other people who were taking Eltroxin had similar symptoms but added hypertension, diarrhea, and fatigue to the list. It took a long time to discover the reason for the new symptoms. The manufacturer of Eltroxin, Merck, changed the inactive ingredients. The active ingredients were still the same, only the inactive binder, lactose, was changed.
At this point, I trust you understand the significance of excipients. If there is a specific supplement you're interested in having reviewed, please feel free to let me know. Your input is valuable in tailoring my content to address your preferences. I sincerely appreciate your time. Please help us to grow this channel by hitting the like and subscribe buttons. Also, share this video with your friends and family. My name is Anna.